The Build Show Build Boston series is sponsored by Allura Fiber Cement Siding, Mitsubishi Electric Train US, Roseburg, Schuco USA, and Warmboard.
Hey, Steve Basic Architect for the Build Show. Yeah, Build Show Build Boston. You know, we always start from the front of the house. I figured, hey, let's go in the back because as the architect, when we were doing the renderings and all of that, this is easily my most favorite view of the house. Now, if you've been following us all along on this project, we've done well over 24 videos. But if you remember the video number one, where I sat down with the homeowner, Scott, we were right in this general area. We were looking back at the original house that was on the site here, the one that we tore down. Well, here we are today. You can see the house is, might not look like it's close to finishing, but it is. We still have a bunch of work on the outside, but as far as the inside goes. And so in this episode, I'm calling it, you know, the best of times, it was the worst of times, because it's the best of times in the sense that we get to see the house, we get to see it in its finished state, we get to turn it over to the homeowner, it starts to become, you know, what it was intended to be, someone's personal home. It's the worst of times because over the last 14 plus months, I've had the opportunity to share with you my passion and what I absolutely love to do and what gets me out of bed in the morning, right? Coming out, walking projects, talking, sharing information, having discussions, meeting new subcontractors, meeting new manufacturers, seeing new products. And, you know, if you've been with us through all 20 plus episodes, you'll understand there's things that I've done here before that I've never done before, companies that I've worked with here that I've never worked with before. And even some companies, like we've been doing engineered floor joist systems and we've been putting in windows every project. But this is the first time I got an opportunity to work with Roseburg and all of their framing products. This is the first time that we used a Schuco USA triple glazed window system, and they were a dream to work with. I've worked with them many a times. Warmboard, who is always a treat to work with, they're highly collaborative effort, and I'm gonna, you know, I'm dumping on the rest of the country because we easily have the very best Warmboard rep here in New England. And if you haven't seen the videos with Julie, you have to watch them. She is entertaining and she is a boatload of information. So go check those out. And of course, you don't build here in New England without the intent to have adequate heating and or cooling in the summer, right? It's freezing cold in the winter and it's a Miami summer in August. So thanks to Mitsubishi for joining us on this journey and getting us in and making sure that we are cozy cool. So anyways, we got Scott inside. We're gonna go in, we're gonna catch up. I actually think he has one of the subcontractors in there where we're making some final selections. So why don't we head in inside and we'll catch up with Scott. All right, so we're gonna catch up with Scott, but before I do, I don't wanna mention it there because we're quite a distance away, but another one of our sponsors for the project was Allura. You know, this is their olive in a 4-inch to the weather. We have their iron ore product. You've seen it in some of the other videos. It's 6 inches to the weather. We used it. This is the smooth finish. It's not the wood grain finish. I think it's an absolutely great pick for what we're doing here. I think it looks beautiful. We have this large mass of a wall here and man, that siding looks good. Lastly, I want you guys to understand that this might be one of the very last episodes of this, but I still have tons of footage for my Friday videos on the Build Show Network, as well as Instagram, LinkedIn, whatever social media account you're looking at. I'll have a bunch of stuff as we do the very final wrap up of this project so that we're not missing a beat. And then we'll try and get back out here when this is all finished, and we'll give you that very final walkthrough. So let's go ahead and catch up with Scott. All right, so we can't do the final episode and not take a walk with the client.
Okay.
And just do a little bit of walk and talk. So
yeah,
he's here in the kitchen. We're talking about countertops, but Scott, I don't want to cut you short, but we got a video to make. So I know we're picking out the countertop.
Yeah,
it's
going to
look beautiful. First class is going to do a first class job.
Oh yeah.
So looking forward to seeing that get cut. But if I could peel you away, why don't we take a quick walk around and
sure,
just have a little summary of what we did here.
Sounds good. We were just spending time because it was a tough decision on quartz for this. But Leo and James from First
Stop
Class.
Stop one second. It's a tough decision for clients. Do you know how quick of a decision it is for me to pick out the countertop? Probably about 2 seconds.
Actually, the amazing thing is...
It's all perspective.
It is perspective. The funny thing is I walked into the warehouse and this was the first... Across the room, this was the first slab that I saw, and I came back.
And then it took 30 hours of deliberation
exactly
to come right back to the starting
line. It's like the Christmas tree.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, I hear you.
Thanks, guys. They came up today and made this sample for me to be able to look at it. Thank you. So we have a decision.
There we go.
What do you think, Steve?
We just need countertops.
Oh, yeah.
It's called London Fog from Ultra Quartz.
Okay, and what's that? That's standard inch and a quarter.
Yeah.
This is an inch and a quarter polished quartz. This right here has a pencil edge on it, which we'll be doing around the kitchen.
Gotcha. How long? What are we talking fabrication time?
Well, this is a two-part turnover. There's going to be countertops and a full height backsplash.
Gotcha.
So you're looking about a week or so.
Okay.
For the entire, from template to final installation.
Slabs are waiting in the warehouse.
Slabs are ready to go.
In stock.
Good.
And they're taking back samples of the bathroom tiles to make, so we can make decisions on vanity tops and things like that.
Looking forward to it.
And I went down to their shop, which is really impressive to see.
It's really always helpful. Great to see where the work's done.
Yeah.
Have a time?
Yes, I'll find some time in the future, and we'll get down there and we'll check it out.
Thank you, guys.
All right, let's hit it, buddy.
Sounds good.
Why don't we start over here at the mud room, and we'll go right through.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
All right, Scott. So we're just off the garage, just south of the mudroom that we'll hit on our way out. So this is the enigma of the project, the plant room.
You keep referring to that in a different way.
And we get all kinds of comments on the plant room. So your partner, Jonathan, he's just a hobbyist. He likes his plants.
And we've got all this space where we're going to try and grow vegetables and so forth and start them early in the year and a big vegetable garden. So that's the goal.
There you go.
Yeah.
So the grow room is all about the vegetable garden and a few interior
and a lot of tropical plants. I bought a few things a few years ago and they've had pups over the years and they're giant, giant trees now. So.
And he's got one hell of a room because he's the only room in the house that has its very own heating and cooling system.
That's because I can't stand the smell of some of the, the plant materials and so forth. So there's actually, the Zender has its own exhaust and supply in
here. To this room too. So it's pretty much, even though it's attached, it's somewhat detached from the rest of the house.
And that was the goal.
And of course, we have due south. In that direction, we have direct access to the outside here. We also have, our beautiful triple glazed Schüco USA windows, tilt turn in the middle, flanked by a couple fixed windows. So we have our, can't see it here, but we have our porcelain OSA tile under here. We have a beautiful drain in here that handles any water issues.
Well, one of the things that I wanted to talk to you about is I've been constantly asked about how we made decisions and what decisions we made as we went along through the process. Mm-hmm. And part of the goal of this series was, I'd always hoped that this series would be the kind of thing that I wanted to have before we started the project.
Gotcha.
And so you learn as you go. And so part of the goal today was to talk about a whole range of things that we just learned from.
Mm-hmm.
And this room has a bunch of things in it. One of the things I've learned is that when you're doing floors, you're doing tile, you're doing other things, you go out and you talk to the manufacturers and you find out how they want it applied, how they want the, what thin sets or what mastic or what adhesives they want to use. And that's been fascinating because some of the subcontractors have changed the companies that they started to use as a result.
Yeah, the manufacturers certainly have their proprietary ways of doing things. I always like to also go to the subcontractors and just say, hey, what is your, your heating system, right? Because the guy that's trained in Mitsubishi and, when there's a problem, like the air conditioning isn't working and it's 100 degrees outside, they're not calling me. They're calling the HVAC guy, so he has to be comfortable with the stuff that he's installing to be able to come out, service it, and such. So,
and they were, we've really been lucky because the Mitsubishi folks have been fantastic, and Chris Johnson's group has been really wonderful in all the installations. So,
and if you haven't seen it, Dave Hazel, who's the local rep, he does a fantastic job. He's been on video with me a whole bunch talking about
Dave's wonderful
systems.
Yeah. So in here, there are a couple things that we talked about. Some of our sinks are finally here. We're putting a sink in here that is another one of the Kraus large, but we're doing a 45 inch, so there's plenty of space. They have that system sink that works well with a lot of the accessories and so forth. And one of the things we also learned in covering the floors, we're using RAM board because I wanted something that was not using OSB or something like that. This is all recyclable. So when this is done, we cut it up and we take it to the recycling facility, and it gets recycled.
Yeah.
Other things as we walk around the house, we have the rest of our cabinets are over there.
Yeah, we can talk about the cabinets when we get in the kitchen. We have our mudroom. We're still, the cabinet maker, he's got a lot of things on his plate, so he's still in the process of making some of the finer stuff. He did get us the kitchen cabinets and the bathroom vanities and such. So the other stuff we could told him, we can put that on the back burner. We'll get that here as the holidays are closing in shortly after. We have our closet doors, our interior carpenters here. He's doing a fine job. We have all of our Brasco doors here, single panel, shaker sticking there, all looking beautiful. We have our washer dryer all in one.
But empty box.
Empty box.
Let's go see the washer dryer.
Around the corner here, and it's in the laundry room. So there it is. Not quite installed, but this is that all in one heat pump dryer washer. Put the load in, and it comes out finished.
This is one of the things I've been most excited about in this house. I know it sounds really crazy, but ventless heat pump, 120 volt. And it gets rid of the problem that I have now where I put clothes in the laundry and
forget to put them in the dryer. These are in the dryer. And I'm assuming you can set it so it cycles from washer to dryer
automatically.
And that's the whole complete.
Yep. The other thing is all of the GE appliances that we picked are all Wi-Fi, all smart.
Gotcha.
So it's controllable by, for delays and so forth.
So if you forget to turn it off and you wanted it off because you left the house, you can just jump on the app and shut her down.
And we haven't finished the design. Well, I think you finished the design. I haven't sort of gotten to review it. But we're putting another sink here, so we have the ability. And the advantage of this has been that, given the size of that it's only it's one unit.
Right.
We don't have.
So it's about half of the linear footage that a typical side by side takes.
And so we have a lot more space here.
Yeah.
So and that we're putting another one of the same sinks from Kraus in here, and one of the exciting things that I wanted to mention also about sinks. Is we're using faucets throughout the house that are also touchless. So they're all sensor-based, which is a new thing that's really, really reliable. I've had them for years in another apartment, but we're excited to have it here.
Well, there you have it.
Yeah.
On to bigger and better rooms. Let's hit that great room. All right, so great room. Kitchen, living, dining room space. I love this space. It's
me too.
Probably my favorite space in the whole house. And it's because it's one room, but it doesn't feel like one room, right? When I'm over here, I feel like I'm in the kitchen. When I'm over there, it feels like the living room. And then of course we have the canopy over there that really sets that dining room space apart.
I think that'll make a big difference when it's done.
I think so too. And of course, my good friend Jeff Model, he's doing all the cabinetry here. He always does a beautiful job. This is all that Roseburg hardwood veneer plywood that we got.
And I love Jeff's details, because as you look at it, I mean, what you set out for the idea of the double thickness there, yeah, makes such a difference in the solid walnut on the front. And then where each of the, can't see it on the camera, but right now, where all these doors fit into an area where it's absolutely flush across the front.
Yeah, he's certainly meticulous about how he does things, how the cabinets get installed. Having his cabinet guys aware that we were putting this on a warm board floor, and that all of their screws were no longer than 1.25 inches, and they didn't fully drive anything.
And the way they mount them, and the way they mount them was just amazing to watch.
Yeah, Jeff he's been doing this a very long time. I've done well over 100 kitchens with him, and he does a fantastic job.
And to Steve's appreciation for Steve did a wonderful job, because the symmetry of this is amazing, and I think all the spacing is wonderful. We also chose to use touch latches on everything, so there are no handles. Yeah. So it's an absolutely clean line everywhere.
Mm-hmm. And we have pull-out drawers, so yep, as you can tell, neither one of us is getting any younger, but you know, having the ability to do full extension glides, yeah, on all of these roll-out drawers gives us the ability to get to the back of the cabinets even when we're getting up there in age.
Yep. And Steve talked about the sinks before, I think, on another video. But one of the other things that I'm really excited about is this 57-inch sink. Yeah. And it's a system sink from Krauss. And the advantage of that is basically you can slide your colanders and other things, and it becomes a food prep area as opposed to just cleaning dishes. And so for us, that's really wonderful, because you know, we will compost everything that's left over from vegetables and so forth, but to be able to make it into a food prep space that is productive and easy to use, I think really makes a difference.
And for those two cook kitchens, I mean, you could literally have two people there doing two totally, yep, different activities in the same sink.
And the how clever this stuff is for a drying rack for a sink too, just for this piece, you know, really amazing. It folds up. They also sell these for your table, for your as a sort of a trivet for your dining room table, which I thought was just cool.
Yeah.
Multiple uses. So really, really smart, thoughtful process that they go through.
And you know, every time I step in front of one of the, you know, large Schüco windows, you can't help but appreciate just how big and how well crafted they are. And, you know, it's one of those things where you guys have often heard me say, it performs as good as it looks, right? These are window and door systems that not only look good, I mean, we have that huge lift and slide door, but it performs. You know, center of glass on this thing is, you know, R10. So it's really important that as an architect and a homeowner, when you're teaming up, that you're having discussions. Not only, you don't just stop the questionnaire when you're talking about things that, hey, how good does that look? What color countertops? What kind of wood should we be using on our cabinetry? There's other questions that are involved, like when I'm 20 years older, am I still going to be able to function in that kitchen? We have two. My wife and I love to cook. Is this a kitchen sink that both of us can cook side by side with? These windows, we're in a northern climate here. Are those windows the right windows for the conditions that we're building here, right? Building a house like this, I know Scott talked a little bit about what he thought was important. My take on design and my passion about architecture has been and will always be that there's thousands of questions to be asked here. And for every question you ask, there's five answers and four of them are right.
Yeah.
Right? And the question is how do I knit that quilt together? And what manufacturers, what products service the needs of my client aesthetically, functionally, but then also from a performance standpoint so that I can be happy in all three, kind of a triple play, if you will, right? So.
And then getting to aesthetics of the, you know, we started out with building envelope was the most important.
Yeah.
And then we get down to the aesthetics of decisions, you know, door handles. I mean, that took a little while. I wanted something that was high quality, went with Baldwin. But you know, just the feeling of that, we put the first one on today.
Yeah.
And it's just a great, Jared and I actually did it, Jared more than me by the end. But it was, you know, it's just a great feeling when you see it come together and you see the design component that is pure aesthetic and quality.
And that's important because not only does it need to look good, but that's a handle that I want to touch every day.
Yep.
So I don't want to touch something that feels flimsy.
Yep.
Right? I want to feel like, okay, according to my checkbook, I spent a significant amount of money on this house. I want to make sure I feel every check that got written and in our as current, I walk through this house.
Our current house has the handles that were put on by a developer, right, and they feel different.
Yeah. He has the check.
Right.
You have the flimsy feel.
Right.
So.
6 years of flimsy feel.
6 years of flimsy feel. So why don't we head over? We'll head over into the bedroom wing. We got the office. We got the bedrooms to talk about. And of course, the owner's bathroom. All right, Scott. So first stop. This is the hallway that connects the great room and the bedrooms. And intentionally, as part of the design, we put the office here as kind of an acoustical buffer. So we don't have a bedroom that is directly adjacent to the great room. What you're not seeing here is we have a beautiful glass wall that is going to get fabricated for this area to separate the hallway from the office space there. But, you know, we don't have that, so you're going to have to use your imagination until we get that in.
Next video.
But the other thing that we can talk about right quick is, you know, we've done the flooring series, but just to reiterate, I mean, this was, I'll give you credit. You searched these guys out. You worked with them. This is Moffy. It's an engineered hardwood floor. If you go check the other videos where we speak about it at length, but it has that, you know, oak finish on top. This is an Austrian white oak, and this is finished.
Yes.
This is a matte finish on there, so it looks like, wow, what are you going to put for a finish? It's every time I showed somebody.
It's a plant oil-based finish. They thermally treat the wood so that it basically is washable then. When you finish doing this, they give you buy a thing of soap.
They have their own proprietary soap.
Proprietary soap. You fill it, you basically put it in a bucket of water, and you just mop the floor, which is sort of radical for a wood floor.
The thing that I absolutely love about that is we sent that wood off to Cape Cod Air Grills, and they cut us custom grills out of the engineered wood floor. So now when this is butting up against it, it looks exactly the same.
That made me really happy because we looked at some of the other options and they just didn't match.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, of course, we could have done stainless steel or some kind of metal, but man, it looks so nice when that matches absolutely perfect.
And one of the other things we found with this floor was also the need to understand the proper way to put it down.
Because
we went through various iterations of the way, the direction it went because of the warm board floors, as well as the...
And I remember it's Vockel.
Vockel.
Vockel. German adhesive.
But that was back to the issue of finding the right element that Moffy supports as one of the things, the adhesives that they will recommend and warrant.
So yeah. I think that's a really good lesson to understand that whether you're the architect, the designer, the homeowner, the subcontractor, if I'm the flooring guy and you say, hey, we're going to put adhesive down, this is a Moffy floor. I've never used it before. Let's give Moffy a call or write to them and say, what adhesive do you recommend? This is what I typically use. And just to understand if there's a compatibility issue with what you're attempting to do and what you typically use versus what they suggest. So why don't we head down? I mean, we have a couple bedrooms here. I don't think there's anything really, you know, necessary to talk there. We have our Jack and Jill bath. We have some more cabinetry. But the real treat on this side of the house is heading down to the owner's suite.
So yeah.
Let's hit that.
Thanks.
All right. So this is the primary bedroom. I mean, it has a beautiful 9-foot square window to look out onto the courtyard.
Thank you,
there,
Steve.
But has a volume ceiling. This is one of the three slope ceilings on the project. This one also has like six kW of solar.
16 panels.
16 panels upstairs there. But I think some of the things in here were more about the decisions of aesthetics that we chose. You know, we have this large transom window here, so we brought that up. We actually made the decision to put outlets on that wall and this wall. So they're a set of twins, so I can put the bed on that wall or put the bed on this wall, either way. And then over here, you'll see you have drywall returns with a very simple 5-quarter sill that we have talked about in different videos. So, I mean, it's simple, but it fits the style of the house.
And we spend a lot of time worrying about the technology in here, mm-hmm. and in all the rooms. But there's behind in this wall, there is all the wiring for TV and smart technology. And all of these outlets are going to be smart outlets.
Yeah.
So we have the control for load management as well as app-based turning things on and turning things off.
Yeah, and this house has every one of those outlets is coded. So you can go on your app, you can be anywhere, and you can shut that specific outlet off or yep. that light switch.
And the nice part is we also were using fans in each of the rooms that are Minka Air that's tied into Nice. So that they are smart, they're smart fans as well, so we have control over that.
Gotcha. And I can see we have our register there. So we, in this house here, if you haven't seen the videos, go check them out, because that's a really important aspect of what we did here. From the performance side, there's not much about Zender that you're gonna sit there and say, oh, I wanna get a Zender because it looks really pretty in my basement. But you need to put it in. We're striving for an air tightness here of below 1.0 ACH 50, 50 Pascals. We have RetroTech. They've been here. You saw the video. If you haven't, go check that out. But our preliminary test has put us right around 1, and it's only going to get better from that test. So we haven't run any of our final testing, but we did do that preliminary one. So we're already within the margin of success for us. And when you're building to that tightness level, and I'll await the comments of how you don't want to build that tight. I'm not going to bring that conversation up again. I'm tired of giving it, to be brutally honest with you. But I strive to build a house as tight as I can. And when I do that, we provide outside air that has been conditioned and filtered, right? And it comes through that vent. We have a CO to monitoring system,
yep.
so that if you're in here and or if you're having a party, we have one on the other side of the house and you have 50 people in there and the monitor says, hey, wait a minute, this is different than our standard operating. We have a lot more CO2, let's kick it on and let's ramp up the Zender system and it'll go into boost mode. And next thing you know, we're getting outside air that is balanced to the occupant load and the activity inside the house.
And back to the indoor air quality, it's a huge thing, because we also, when we were originally planning all this, we found that the old house had radon.
Right.
We went through a whole process of looking at radon with Air Things as monitors and working with April Air on yep. on the fans and so forth, and really planning that out. And also finding that we weren't the only ones. There were a lot of neighbors who had the same problem.
Yeah, and we have a dual, again, because of the, go check out some of the earlier videos where this is a very large floor plan. From this side to the other side of the house is about 170 linear feet. And so to put one vent in and think that that's going to do a great job, we actually split up a bunch of the services just because of the shape and the amount of square footage spread out. So, and yeah, April Air, we work with them. We have our exhaust fans there should the system need to go from a passive to an active system.
Yeah, and we also put in a humidifier and dehumidification.
Yeah.
And we shouldn't, you know, we really don't think we're going to need much dehumidification, because with the hot water heaters that are heat pump,
yeah,
that should take care of a lot of it.
Taking a bunch of the moisture out of the air downstairs for us and putting it into your water heater that you can turn into shower hot water. So, speaking of shower hot water,
let's go take a look.
All right, Scott.
This is turning out wonderful.
That's a Steve size shower, and you're not Steve size.
You can tell.
Yeah. But no, this is a pretty gorgeous setup you have in here.
But it's actually relatively simple. I mean, this is porcelainosa tile that we picked.
You know the name of the finish on that one? It's all right if you don't. We can put it in the comments.
I think it's Glem. It's Glem White.
Okay.
But it was a cool tile because it's a matte finish with very little veining, but it still has character to it. And we chose it for the tile in the shower on all walls and the ceiling and the two walls behind the vanities.
Right. Sure.
And I'm really excited to see this because I also, having done some tile work, I absolutely fell in love with this whole system that they're using for making sure every tile has the right gap and has the right, that they're absolutely dead flat.
Yeah, the displacement on the face of the tile when you're using this system here, it's spot on in getting that, you know, you can run your finger down there and it's all in exactly the same plane.
And so, thanks to Leo and Gabriel for great work.
Yeah,
thanks,
you know,
guys.
These guys have been nonstop on the success train.
And we chose, water is an important thing in this house for several, for a number of reasons, and we'll talk about several of them. We wanted to make sure that, one, we were managing water, so we're putting in a system from a company from Lixil called Hydrific that actually tells us how much water we're using.
Okay.
So it'll manage that and tell us when there's a problem. And having just seen some articles about people who got surprise water bills for radical amounts of money in the town we're living in now, because they did estimates for a long time and then they... This, we'll actually know exactly how much we're using. We're using all GROA mix valves that are the kind you just set for a temperature and automatically adjusts based upon what the water's coming in, which is key because we're using drain water heat recovery.
Right.
So we'll talk about that later, but the drain water heat recovery means that you're putting in, you're putting warmer water into the cold line that comes up here. Mm-hmm. And that means you're constantly changing based upon how much water is going down the drain and being effectively preheating the water that's coming in,
right,
both half to the water heater and half to the cold line.
Gotcha. And I see the guys, they're putting in the brackets here. We're going to have a floating bench of, I'm assuming it's quartzite.
It's going to be quartz, but what's really interesting is Leo and James from First Class have shown me this system, which is really wonderful because it's, they make a box effectively that slides over those brackets.
Yeah, and it just slides into
it.
So you never see it. If you even dropped something and looked up, you wouldn't see it. And then the guys from Peterson here, Rodrigo's crew, they were putting the brackets in, but they're going to get fully waterproofed and buried in the water management system that's part of the Porcelanosa brand, right?
And I love this. I love the combination of the water management, the water barrier in the improband, and the decoupling layer they have, in the, plus the shower. You're gonna show the shower. I think in another video.
Yeah. So I can't show you it right now because obviously we're doing a whole bunch of work. We have a ton of protection there, but stay tuned. I'm gonna do a final walkthrough. I think scheduled for next week. My good buddy Matt. He's gonna come up from Texas. I'm not telling him that it might be a little cool out here, but we'll see. I'm sure he comes up in his Eskimo gear. And but we'll make sure we have some of that off. And but I can give you a teaser. We have a shower pan that has no drains. So stay tuned. Catch up with us next week, and we'll talk a little bit more about that.
That is one of the coolest things.
That is one of the coolest things. I've never even seen anything like that until we've done it on this project. So... that's awesome. You know, one of the other things that I think I would love to have in my own house, you know, we have a door here that obviously we can open. We go outside, there'll be a deck there, and we have an outdoor shower out here. So imagine every morning you can wake up and you have your choice. Do I want to shower outdoors or indoors today? And you have a door that solves that problem for you. So.
And we also were making sure with all the plumbing that the plumbing was designed in such a way that it's very easy for us in the winter to take the mix valve right off the wall.
Yeah, and pop that mix valve off, drain the pipes down into the basement, and it's a
growy unit that just pops off, and then you have the drains downstairs.
Yeah,
it's really cool.
So, what do you say? We'll head back to the great room because I think we should wrap this up with. We can have a little bit of talk about all the intelligent technology that we put into this house.
Sounds good.
So, let's hit it. All I can say is I'm glad my mom or dad didn't have access to a tool like this when I was a kid. That's all I can say. So,
that's a Steve-sized paddle.
Yeah. So, and
isn't that gorgeous?
Well, it's very nice. I'm surprised that, honestly, how light it is.
Yeah.
So, for those of you that aren't familiar, this is a fan blade. You can see we have the attachment here where it gets attached to the housing. You can see how it's scalloped here so that we're moving air. And it's got that kind of oaky finish. So, you know, when it's up against the ceiling, this is going to match the flooring very, very nicely. But like all the other fans and our speakers, sound system, our lighting or shading controls, security, all of that is through NICE.
Yeah, it's all integrated. So many of these things, you have like 14 apps for them.
Right.
And the idea is it's one app, and it's all integrated together. And that's where they have a partnership with a lot of other companies, including Minka Air, where they integrate this fan into that whole ecosystem. And that was something I really liked, because that you can set for temperatures, you can set for a lot of different things, yeah. And you have control over it. And I also, you know, one of the things we really are shooting for in this house is creating data sets to tell us how we're doing.
Whatever the search that you have, it's really funny because, you know, I pride myself on being at the forefront of technology when it comes to building envelopes and stuff, but I like to think of the things that I favor are more passively activated, not active, right? So when people get into smart technology, you know, oh, I could tell you exactly how many gallons of water you used on your shower. Me personally, I say, well, I really don't give a damn, because I'm not going to change my shower strategy because I used 13.2 gallons of water today, and yesterday I used 11.7, and I'm 2 gallons over on my hot water. So it's one of those things. I think it's really great that we have this information that people can understand. And as a dad, I will tell you, I would have loved to be able to have a dashboard where I could stand my son in front of and say, please tell me there's a reason why we used 86 gallons of hot water today in your shower.
It was Stevos, not your daughter's.
Stevos. No, Stevos was, yeah, I have no idea why. But anyways, it's one of those technologies where I think it's important. Information is always important. It's a question of what do I do with that information? What is that information burden? And NICE is a company that's trying to solve that for us, right? Because they're not saying, well, we'll handle your security and we'll handle your shading devices. You got to get somebody else to handle the AV equipment or your fans. They're trying to fully integrate it so that now if you have a problem, you have a problem with one company, not 14 different apps.
Right. And it's interesting, when you raise the water issue, one of the reasons that water was very, I was sensitive to usage, well, there are several reasons. One of them, I've been involved in a community water company. Whenever there's a leak, I get a call. And the second is the house that was here before, when we bought, they had used 75,000 gallons of water in the 9 months before we bought the house, but nobody was living in the house.
Right.
So it was a bad toilet flapper. And no one knew that, and they just kept paying the bill. And I think that, you know, awareness of that. And so when we put on it,
for about $15, they could have saved a boatload of money.
Well, a little more than 15, but for 100 and some bucks. And so we put an early technology on that literally flagged it when I had a bad gasket on a hose and sent me an email saying I had a potential leak for 0.1 gallons per minute.
Right.
And that was pretty impressive.
Yeah.
So I really like those technologies. And I'm really happy also with the solar array and the batteries and participating in a peak demand program where the utility can literally pull the power out of our batteries for up to 60 days in the summer to meet peak demand between 2 and 7 p.m. We also looked at all the issues of backup. And part of the backup scenario is, you know, having that smart technology so that it automatically knows when the system goes, when the power goes off, you know, what systems shut down, what systems you don't need, and having control to then say, we're going to turn off other things as the outage goes longer. And if you're in the middle of winter versus summer, you know, how much you're generating per day.
Well, from the standpoint of loving that kind of getting that kind of information, you know, there's a lot of manufacturers will say, hey, buy this because this is a low consumption TV or whatever it is. And it's like, okay, well, low consumption in their eyes might mean a marketing scheme. In my eyes, I'm looking for real-time low consumption. And it takes me back to a house, a Zero Energy Plus house that I did for a good friend, Dan Roy, and I'm sure you talked to him early on.
Great guy.
And but one of the things we learned at his house was the cable box was the biggest draw. And it was like having 2.5 or 3 refrigerators in that house, that one cable box.
And,
you would have never guessed it if you weren't testing for it.
And with the Schneider, the way we're going, the Schneider system, we could basically program that so it automatically goes off. It automatically comes on at certain hours of the day or goes off at certain hours of the day, meaning right. shuts down the power to it.
So all those phantom loads of things like your coffee maker that's running the little clock or
yep.
whatever that's still draining power from your system, you can coordinate all those efforts and you don't need the company to be smart consumption because you're cutting the wire, literally.
And all of our appliances are smart. So I haven't had the experience of working with them yet to see how that all plays out. But we tried to go with appliances that were more efficient, innovative, and so forth, and also that were not the very high-end and high-cost appliances.
Right.
We picked Profile because they are, you know, I've used them before. They're very reliable, and I like the features and the innovations.
Yeah, and they look good. They look really good.
They look great, and I'm really impressed with what I've seen. So,
yeah.
And did I mention before I love the washer dryer?
Yes, you did mention that. You did mention it, but I'll let you mention that one again because that is pretty cool. If you say it again, I might put the paddle to use. but that's enough about that washer.
I don't want that one.
But I don't know. Anything else? I think we've certainly done it justice.
Yeah, I think, you know, there are so many lessons learned in this process. You know, there were projects that I took on that Steve thought I was crazy to take on. Was that correct?
Yeah. And I still think you were crazy for taking them on. I would have suggested you didn't do them. But
one of them was putting in the tubing for the warm board floors and doing all the custom cuts. And those custom cuts, you know, were a major lesson to see how that process worked. It took me longer than I said it was going
to
take me.
I mean, there's only one way to really understand and learn how to do something. And that's to do it.
So. And that's been a fun part of this process as we've gone through it, is the ability to go and try some of these things. And we've had some wonderful folks working on the project, which has been really rewarding to see. You all met Rodrigo and Elvis and so many of the other players. And Jesus,
Jesus. I still go around and I tell everybody, I said, you ain't going to believe it. I have this incredible project where I'm working with Jesus and Elvis, right? So, and people are like, what? And I was like, listen, I'm not lying here. I'm not lying. Both Jesus and Elvis were helping me out.
Jesus' advanced green insulation was just absolutely marvelous. And we were very lucky with timing to be able to move from what we had planned for insulation to Timber HP with wood fiber blown in. And now we're going to use some of their new bats as they're coming out shortly.
Yeah. And I think before we wrap up, I'll shout out a huge list because I met some new contractors on here. Some guys I knew, like Walsh, the concrete guy. I've known him for years because of an association with another builder, but having to get him out here, if you haven't seen that episode on the foundation, I mean, the guy with a couple string lines set up a perfect foundation.
That was brilliant to watch.
System. Yeah, just watching these guys. It's one thing to sit there, yes, in AutoCAD, I could draw a straight line, I can make sure it's a 90 degree angle, but for homeowners, it's one of those things to assume like, yeah, that's just gonna happen. Like, we have probably 480 linear feet of foundation wall in this house. And to make sure that every corner is a true 90, that wall is absolutely parallel to the front wall, so that when our contractor, Matt King, shows up, he can then do his job knowing that the guy in front of him did their job and did it well. And then he can leave the project for everybody else, the interior guys hanging the doors, that they can ensure that, yeah, all the doorways were nice and true and plumb because he did his job. So.
And Larry was very responsive to the fact we changed it literally the day before we were pouring. We changed and added a bulkhead door in the back.
Yeah.
And Shea Concrete came out with a precast and bolted it in, and we put a Bilco door on the top, and that's been absolutely marvelous for anyone getting access to the back of the house.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, all these little things that you learn that are can be last minute decisions. Larry was wonderful about responding to that.
Yeah, and our drywaller, I forget his first name.
Mike.
Mike. Mike did a fantastic job. If you haven't seen that. He is probably one of the best interviews or camera counterparts that, you know, I had standing with me on camera, and he just took it away.
And how many of these companies are third or fourth generation?
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, Mike's fourth generation from 1932.
Yeah. So he did a hell of a job. We had Brennan Electric out here, you know, did a beautiful job. Elvis put in the floors. His guys were meticulous. I mean, I remember walking in, you know, as an architect, it's like, yeah, out here, of course they're going to do a good job. Everybody sees this. But when I go in the back room in the corner of the closet and the guy is making sure every cut is precise, you know you got the right team on the job.
Yep.
Right? And of course, you know, Chris Johnson and his crew.
Oh, Chris was wonderful.
Doing the Zender. And it's always nice. We had the Zender system commissioned. Zender actually gave a big shout out to, hey, these guys did a really good installation job. And I know we had Dave from Mitsubishi here a number of times, and he said the same thing. He's known Chris Johnson. Dave's our rep here in New England. And, you know, he talked very highly of Chris Johnson, talked very highly of the install that we have here.
And Chris was a great example for someone where, with a homeowner, there are so many questions and so many issues. Chris was literally a phone call away at any time.
Yeah.
And just absolutely wonderful to work with. And that's been part of the process that's been great about this whole situation. Yeah. One of the other things I want to mention, you mentioned, I think, the Roseburg. One of the great things that I had the opportunity to do was tag along with Steve when we went out to Roseburg.
Yeah, we have a huge bonus video where we went up there and we literally went out into the mountains and I got to walk with the lumberjacks and, you know, we watched trees get cut, pulled up the hill, we got a full tour. But
with hundreds of due diligence trips over my career, that was one of the highlights, to be able to see that and be out at I love the factories, but the forests were the best.
Yeah,
and
that was an outstanding trip. It was really cool to see where all of this framing came from and where it originated. And their process of how do they take it from tree to engineered floor joist or LVL, the things that, you know, we go to a lumber yard and, you know, the contractors buy this stuff, but we just kind of take it for granted that lumberyard is going to have that LVL. Well, there's literally thousands of people that are doing other stuff. And we'll use that trip as an example. The woman that was in the laboratory, like Roseburg has people in the laboratory to figure out how to regenerate a better forest. So they're working with the different seeds and seedlings and such, and trying to figure out how can we put back a better forest than the one we just cut down. And so a lot of these companies, they're not just about, hey, let's cut the trees down, let's make a lot of money selling a bunch of wood. They're trying to encompass this whole cycle of their activities where they're being responsible every step of the way.
And I think as what a third generation company, you know, the forest management was probably the most impressive thing to see, that they are committed to that. And I got to have 2+ hours with Scott, who was their head of forestry, in the car with questions. And I don't know if he'll recover, but it was...
He hasn't?
Okay.
He's mentioned it many a times.
There were a lot of questions asked at that point.
Yeah.
But he's actually going in from everything from dealing with not just the trees, but having to build roads to get up to take the tree, to plant the trees, and then to cut the trees and so forth.
Yeah.
Just truly amazing. So it's been an amazing process. And to sort of end this process as we're doing it, where the kitchen is going in and where we're using their amazing plywood, that was very, very, I was very happy moment for me when we decided on the walnut and then saw the quality of the product.
So one of the additions to, you know, the fact that we have a full Roseburg framing package here, we got to go up there and check that out. And the tour, you know, there's a lot of areas where Roseburg can't work by itself. So it needs joist hangers, it needs screws.
What did you say, it doesn't hold itself up?
Doesn't hold itself up, right? I mean, in some aspects it can, but there's certainly some large beams downstairs and some joists that we had to hang. So we called upon our good friends at Simpson Strong Tie, and we worked with them to get the, you know, latest generation of hangers and the right technology, had it reviewed by their engineers to make sure that we were making the right decisions.
And we're even using their product on the deck that's about to be put in
for
carriers and so forth.
So they're inside, outside.
You've taught me a lot about how that plays out and how important it is.
Yeah. So
go back and watch that video where Steve does a great job.
Just another great company that's, you know, part of the whole system here.
And really responsive when you need to ask a question and find a quick solution to something, you can call their tech support people. As with, also with Huber was magnificent in that. When there
yeah,
were questions
we have our
that came
Zip
out.
R9, we have yep. the rain screen system on the outside here underneath our Allura. So again, we have all these companies, we stitch that quilt together beautifully. And not only, you know, you're going to say it again, because I'm trying to beat this into the building industry. Not only does it look good, but it performs as good as it looks. All right. So as you can see, I lost Scott for a minute. He got tied up. He's got a couple questions to answer. So I figured I'd jump over here. You know, these are Brasco doors. Like I said, they're single panel, shaker stuck. These are all pre-primed, pre-hung doors. You know, one of the things that I absolutely love about these is that we're bringing back polished chrome. Yes, Build Show, Build Boston. I'm going to go out on a limb here, and we are bringing back polished chrome. Just on this job, we're bringing it back. So satin nickel, bye-bye. Polished chrome is where it's at, right? I absolutely love it, the decision to move towards all of that hardware. But anyways, we have the door stud caddy system. It's in place. For those of you not aware, this actually won Best of Show 2023 at the International Builder Show. So what is the door stud? Well, it's a caddy system. You can see we have our pre-hung door here. We're using our beautiful single panel shaker stuck door panels. These are pre-hung on the frame, and the caddy here is built to basically grab the door, and it has these handles on each side where I can basically put this into the door opening as a single person installing these, drop that down and install the door hands-free of actually holding the door itself. And you can see it's very easily maneuvered, right? The casters obviously, you know, spin in all directions. I could take this, have all the doors staged at one side, bring out my door caddy and take it across the house, put it in that door opening and, you know, have full access. If I spin it around, you'll see down on the nailing side, I have access to install it, properly shim it, all of that. And yeah, I don't know. Really cool idea. You know, it's really interesting. A lot of what we're doing in the building industry these days are, you know, it's about making things easier, but you can imagine being an interior trim carpenter and lugging doors for 30 years, right? At some point, you might get a little tired. Some of the body parts might get a little worn. So, door stud caddy solves a lot of those problems. And then of course, you know, LDS, who was the general contractor here, did a very fine job. It was a pleasure to be working with Kevin and Jared along the way, bringing this project to life. You know, I have a couple other projects. I have another one coming up with those guys. Always a pleasure to show up on a job site and chat with those guys. And then for me personally, as we close this out, I'll say thank you to you and Jonathan for giving me the opportunity to be part of this. I know we've had our fun, and I know it's my personality to say, you know, Scott, shut up. All right?
Just shut never, up. No, never. Yeah.
You know, because I don't want to hear it. But we've had our fun along the way, but all kidding aside, this has been one of the, you know, my favorite projects I've ever done. And it's not because it's been on camera. It's the house, the decisions you and Jonathan made, the fact that before you talk, you listen, you understand why I'm suggesting what I do, and then you make your decisions. And it's okay if you don't agree with me, that's fine. I kind of like a challenge. It forces me to think beyond where I'm thinking. But I get some clients that immediately, like you show them something and they just, I have to listen to, you know, 20 minutes of a rant on why we don't want to do this, we hate that, do this. And they have no idea. And when I get into it, then it's like, oh, well, I didn't realize you would have, you know, those were the decisions that created this situation to which these two decisions were made, right? So you and Jonathan were certainly extremely good clients. And you're be certainly at the top of my list for what I would, you know, consider a very great career. So thank you very much.
Well, thank you. It's, yeah, as I've said at the beginning, it's a collaboration and it's a partnership. And, you know, I feel happy every time I come into this house. And where we've been living without power for a period of time, it's been temp power. One of the things that's amazing to come into this house is to feel when you're using two very inexpensive heaters from Costco to heat the entire house. Yeah. That says something about the quality of the.
And all the contractors are taking off their jackets and they're walking around here in a t-shirt, because not only does the house look good, but it performs as good as it looks. So
thanks.
I'm going to close it out. This isn't the last video. We got one more. Of course, we got to bring Matt up. And like I told you, be prepared for a laugh, because I'm sure he's bringing Eskimo gear. We've made it into December. He's coming up from Texas. There's no way he's coming up here in a t-shirt. So, I'm sure he'll have something. But anyways, we got one more video. We got Matt coming up. We'll show you what that shower looks like. We'll do a little walk with Matt. But I'm Steve Basic Architect. This is Scott. This is our Build Show Build Boston.
Thanks, Steve.
You got it, buddy. Until Matt arrives.